Moin and hello, I'm Lothar from A-Games, and in my tutorial about how to use Epic Online Services with Unreal Engine Blueprints, I talked about the confirmation screens when logging into EOS. I mean these annoying screens. I kind of ranted about Unreal Engine 4.27.2, because we are not able to use persistent login with the online subsystem EOS to avoid these confirmations. And also, login failures do not trigger the login failed node. Both of these problems have been fixed in Unreal Engine 5. That's great work by Epic Games, and personally, I'm very happy they fixed these issues. Unfortunately, Epic Games also introduced new EOS bugs in Unreal Engine 5. In order to address the new bugs, I will be posting an Unreal Engine 5 troubleshooting video soon. But first of all, in this video, I'm providing a short update on my EOS tutorial concerning persistent login. The sequence of actions when using persistent login is as follows. After starting the multiplayer mode of a game, at first we try a so-called persistent EOS authentication. What happens there is that EOS checks whether it stored some previous authentication token that can be used to re-log in. If this fails, meaning that no such previous authentication is available, we initiate the account portal login as usual. The benefit is that the account portal login is no longer used each login. Instead, it is only used if required. Trying persistent login first and using account portal login only if it is necessary is actually nowadays the process recommended by Epic Games, if we are not using the Epic Games Store. See their documentation page, link below this video. Now, how do we use persistent login with blueprints? Just open the EOS Blueprints project from my EOS tutorial. There's a link to the tutorial below this video, using Unreal Engine 5. Go to the Widget Blueprint main menu. And open the login macro. Currently, we are using the auth type account portal. There is a new auth type with Unreal Engine 5 called persistent auth. If this type is specified, EOS tries to use a persistent token from a previous login. So, instead of simply using the auth type account portal, we are creating a second login node. And we are using auth type persistent auth first. And only if this fails, we are using the account portal login. Last but not least, we need to properly connect the new login node. If we test this using Unreal Engine 5, we will note that the confirmation screen is only shown if there is no persistent auth available, but not for follow-up logins. That's great! If you encounter a crash when running the EOS Blueprints project using Unreal Engine 5, join the club. I'm currently preparing a troubleshooting video to help you implement workarounds for current issues with the online subsystem EOS. And that's it for this small update. Have a wonderful time!